February 1976, is blessed with over 9 million hectares of vast tracts of rich and cultivable land, representing about 10% of the country's land mass. Unfortunately, less than 30% is being utilized, leaving 70% of the arable land for agri-related investment. The state, from its creation, has had administrators and governors who, in their unique ways, made contributions to the growth and development of the state. As an economist and entrepreneur, Governor Abubakar Sani Bello is committed to developing the infrastructure with a view to supporting the exploitation of their abundant natural resources across the state. Seeking sustainable long-term investment that will support rapid growth and development of the state is also aimed at transforming the lives of the people and make the state less dependent on statutory allocation. To implement the policy and ensure its success, the Abubakar Sani Bello-led administration held an investment summit to introduce Niger State to global community with emphasis on impact investment. The first Niger State Investment Summit with the theme Impact Investment for Advancing Agricultural Economy and Innovation attracted political leaders, a quorum of eminent entrepreneurs, industry chieftains, financial experts, traditional rulers, and key government officials, as well as many other people of all walks of life. For 2 days, discussants exchanged ideas and knowledge, while delegations of eminent entrepreneurs indicated their intention to invest in the state. The Dangote Group's delegation to the 2017 Niger State Investment Summit was led by the company's Group Executive Director, Stakeholders Management and Corporate Communications, Ahmed Mansour.
Niger State is indeed a very virile location for agriculture investment. And we have, as I said in my goodwill message, we are committed to investing over $1 billion in the next 5 to 10 years in agriculture, in various areas. And we're looking at all the states. And I believe that Niger State, in fact, offers one of the best opportunities for us.
Africa will be the growing market in the world. And this project in Niger State, this conference, is a good indication of where you're going.
You already have Siemens. Siemens are actually planning to set up an industrial park. They need a state they could use for that. We have now managed to convince them. So obviously we have the representative of the CEO of Siemens on this particular panel that's just about to start to show how serious they are. We had the talks with them yesterday and they seem pretty excited about it. And the Dangote Group, as I said, are willing to work and partner with the state to make sure that this actually, you know, pulls through and all.
The essence of the summit is for us to let them know what we are in Niger State, what we have, the agricultural potentials we have, advantages and so on to investors so that they can come and avail themselves of the business opportunities that are available, that are abundant.
Vice President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, applauded the effort of Governor Abubakar Sani Bello for explaining that the state has the capacity to feed both the country and about half of the African continent.
Even in the best days of oil dominance in Nigeria, agriculture provided jobs for 30% of our population and about the same percentage contribution to GDP. It is agriculture that is the surest pathway to diversifying our economy, to ensuring food security, and improving our foreign exchange earnings. We've always known these facts. We've always known that the fundamentals of sustainable growth and development for Nigeria is not in the hydrocarbon industry. It is in agriculture and agribusiness. But knowledge and resources have never been our problem. Our problem has always been translating resources and knowledge to positive action and results, which is why this summit is so important. The incredible potential of Niger State requires translation to jobs, to public revenues, and prosperity for all.
In their contributions to the investment summit, former President Olusegun Obasanjo, who chaired the event, and General Abdusalami Alhaji Abubakar advocated the need for government at all levels to make funding, land and labor available to investors at generous rates to support the development of the agricultural sector in the country.
If you have anything to take us out of recession and lift us up as a nation, it is a green business, not oil, not minerals. It is a green business because that is the renewable business that we can do to sustain us and to give us all the job creation that we need, all the wealth creation that we need, particularly for our to raise up the poor among us.
In Nigeria, the interest rate ranges from 18% to 25%, while the loan for the anchor farmers is at 9%. But internationally, while these interests are 2.5, please correct me if I'm wrong, at 2.5. I think maybe the ex-president, sir, although banks are commercial people, you might like to draw a line for them. They should not talk about these interest rates.
Niger State Governor Abubakar Sani Bello, who highlighted investment opportunities that abound in the state to include large arable land for agriculture, large water bodies for irrigation, farming and tourism, and mineral resources, pledged to partner any investor to leverage on areas of comparative advantage.
This organized summit is a partnership towards facing the realities of current economic challenges. There are several benefits tied to this event. It is a significant step by our government to demonstrate the potentials and comparative advantages to investors that Niger State possesses. The immense competitive return on investment which will ultimately make positive impacts on the lives of the people. Thus, the summit aims to present those sectors of the state's economy that are prioritized due to the competitive advantage in terms of impact, ease of doing business, and opportunities of job creation.
There were goodwill messages by the Governor of Sokoto State, Aminu Waziri Tambuwal, Sultan of Sokoto, Sa'ad Muhammadu Abubakar III, Itsunope, and Chairman Niger State Council of Traditional Rulers, Alhaji Yahya Abubakar, as well as captains of industries and others. A few weeks later, the first Niger State Investment Summit started yielding positive results. A subsidiary of Dangote Group of Companies made a commitment to investing 166 billion naira for the development of an integrated sugar project on 16,908 hectares of land in Lavun local government area of Niger State. The signing of the Memorandum of Understanding by the Niger State Government and a subsidiary of Dangote Group of Companies for the development of an integrated sugar project in the state is the culmination of negotiation that began in 2013. The project, which will include a sugar refinery, sugar plantation, and an outgrower scheme to produce 12,000 tons of cane per day, to be crushed and refined into high-quality sugar. The plant is also expected to produce frumbigas and molasses. The president of Dangote Group of Companies, Aliko Dangote, who is a firm believer in the vast economic potentials of Nigeria, said the plant, when fully operational, will generate over 150,000 employment opportunities. Aliko Dangote also indicated the company's desire to invest in rice production by establishing a rice milling factory to process 200,000 metric tons of paddy rice to be sourced mainly by an outgrowers scheme.
Well, you know, the workers, because we are producing quite a lot, if we, by the time we get the balance of the land, if we have 12,000 TCD, you are taking more than 30,000 jobs. And by 30,000 is direct, but then there will be a lot of indirect. But where we will have the most effect is having the outgrower system, you know, because outgrower, you don't have to be within our land, you can have your own land. We give you the good sugarcane seeds, and then, you know, we give you fertilizer, we give you all the insect, the implements, and then we guarantee you a price of, you know, your own sugar, you know, and that is the way to empower people. And we do quite a lot in terms of community development, you know, apart from hospitals, roads, and also making sure that, you know, there are other businesses that will develop out of that business.
Niger State Governor Abubakar Sani Bello described the signing of the agreement as a major success in his drive to attract investors to the state and fruit of the recently concluded investment summit. The state governor, Abubakar Sani Bello, said his administration is considering passing legislation to protect investors and woo other investors to the state.
I'm a very happy man, and indeed I believe all Nigerites will be happy for what happened today. It is our responsibility as a state government to protect investors' interests, and at the same time it's our responsibility to also protect the community's interests. So we're acting as middlemen in this whole transaction, and the model as it is designed, I believe, is very workable, and it will be a win-win situation for everyone. We're working with Dangote Group to ensure that the community is adequately and properly compensated. All measures will be put in place so that everyone gets what is due to him or her. At the same time, we put measures so that in future, after paying compensation, we don't want someone to come back and say he hasn't been compensated. We have had incidences where compensations were paid, and later on children or grandchildren will come and say they have not been paid compensation. So we're going to do everything necessary to ensure that the investor is protected very well, we'll pay compensation, and it will be on record that compensation was paid adequately.
The signing of the agreement by the two parties featured goodwill messages by the critical stakeholders in the project.
Sugar, as of today, the nation imports almost 96% of its requirement. And that tells you the deficit involved. 96% of what we use is being imported. So by the time we develop this local capacity, we save the dear need foreign exchange, which is very scarce as of today. And then, as I said, we give employment to our people and we build local capacity.
From the time we got information about this project, you know, we decided to give appropriate advice that instead of selling the land in totality and collecting money by people who are living now, and subsequently after 20 years, you find another group of people claims to say, okay, we should deviate from that arrangement. If we make a very concrete and then what you know, viable arrangement whereby we just lease the land So that is released out. Those who are living now will maybe live for a period of maybe we'll talk of 10, 15, 20 years. Then thereafter, you know, certain royalties will be paid to people who are living now. Then after that period, another set of people who now maybe they enter and negotiate with the company to increase the tenorship. So with that arrangement, we discover that there will be only future crisis whereby maybe the sons or maybe the children of the present day, you know, parents will now rise up and then start kicking against the development of the company. So that arrangement is going to be in place.
Another investor also made a commitment to invest in $3.2 billion for the development of an agricultural city in Tegina on 42,000 hectares of land in Rafi local government area of Niger State. At the end, we took some participants on their impressions and experience.
The need for this to continue every year, I think it's rather coming at the right time. So I should encourage that His Excellency should continue to do this, but I can assure you that by this time next year, we'll have a good story to tell about how far we've gone.
It makes smart economics for the state to actually have it now. It is timely, it is never late. What remains is for us to conclude it today and come out of it with the smart, real-time economics that we need and a plan so that we forge forward and actualize, be able to galvanize all the investment opportunities into Niger State and to make a pathway by way of policies, serious developmental policies that we enrich whatever we are able to achieve here.
The banks need to consider the interest rates and see how possibly they can help the common man, the investors, the farmers, to be able to perform and make profit out of what they are doing, and then thereby to develop the economy.
Interest rates is a function of rates in the market. It's also a function of the rates, the monetary policy rates that are being given by the central bank. It's also a function of the costs of funding to banks. So when you add all this, the banks now arrive at what interest rate will be applied to loans for customers. But the concerns that were raised yesterday, if you're going to finance agriculture with funding from commercial banks, direct funding, which is in two digits down, it's not going to be a profitable venture for farmers. So the way to go around it is to seek alternative funding. And this can be through grants from international donors, this can be through investments from the international community, and this can be through special arrangements from central bank or some of the government agencies. So for agriculture to do well, for us to be able to get the right rates to lend and fund agriculture, we have to look for alternative sources of funding that will come to us cheap, and so we can lend also cheap to the farmer. That is the only way we can fund agriculture. But if we go on the prevailing rates in the market today, there's no way you can fund agriculture from these loans at two-digit rates, and then it's going to be profitable to the farmer.
Now, this summit actually dovetails into what we're doing for the government in Shea Butter. There's a lot of work in terms of, you know, consulting with the people, understanding their needs before you can set up a master plan, a roadmap to this kind of development. So we're working on that, and when that is ready, it will automatically begin to be a platform on which the state can stand to reach out to the funds that are actually available for developing the share industry in the state. And the governor is right, that Niger State is the largest producer of shea products in the whole world, even though it doesn't get any mention anywhere in the world for it, because most of the shea products here are smuggled out into other countries and they are labeled as coming from those countries. That don't even have, some of them don't even have any shea tree at all. But because, you know, the industry, the economy has not been fully developed in Niger State, so other people are taking advantage of what actually belongs to the state. Our plan is to stop that and also to increase the value so that the local populace can benefit from their labor.
Niger State's government is actually calling the entire world or the entire country, the entire investors, you know, to come and invest in agriculture in Nigeria. In Niger State, they have the what it takes, you know, to actually fill the nation and at the same time to fill the entire ECOWAS region, you know. So it's a very good event, and everybody has really learned one thing or the other, you know. And we have seen the capability of a Niger State in terms of what they have, in terms of resources, in terms of labor, in terms of, you know, all the other resources that can be used to actually bring up the state.
The summit has been very impressive. The outing, at least for the first time in Niger State, it has been host, and that the response yesterday and everything, and this will help a lot in terms of agriculture development, because most of the 70% of the people in Niger State, they are farmers. So I'm sure with what has happened yesterday, with the contribution made by the dignitaries, is going to help a long way in moving Niger State forward.
With continued support, more will be achieved in all spheres of the state economy.